Just because something's old doesn't mean it should have to go away, right? Find out this week on 10 Pin Life. What is up, you guys? Welcome to 10 Pin Life. In this video, we are going to talk about the three reasons why I think they should ban urethane and the three reasons why I think they shouldn't. If you are a fan of 10 pin bowling and content like this, please be sure to hit the like button, share this with your friends, and also subscribe to the channel. In 1980, the game of bowling changed. AMF released the angle, Fayball released the now what is considered the black hammer, and urethane was brought onto the market. Since then, urethane has not gone away. It has existed in arsenals since its release. It has been updated over time slightly, but really, urethane's urethane. It hasn't changed all that much. You will still see it in tournament arsenals everywhere, and actually, it's made a bit of a resurgence here in the last few years during the big USBC tournaments, as well as on the Pro Tour. But with this resurgence has come a discussion about whether or not urethane should be banned from the modern sport of bowling. The way that urethane transitions a lane pattern is completely different from what reactive balls do, and this has incited this discussion about whether or not USBC should consider outlawing that type of cover stock technology. Now, I am going to preface this and say I in no way think USBC is even considering outlawing urethane, but for the sake of the conversation, let's talk about the three reasons why I think they should consider banning urethane. The first reason is all for the proprietors. Urethane is really hard on the front part of the lane. Not only is the actual cover stock harder, so it's going to hit the lane harder, it also tends to push oil down the lane and will actually allow more of an opportunity for less of that protective coating, which we've just known as conditioner for a very long time now, to actually push away from the front. So where we have all of these really dry, really porous resin balls, now they're just hitting that and it's just tearing into the lane panels, really just kind of developing a friction burn. And because of the fact that you really can't move with urethane, it also starts to develop this track area right in the front, especially if you have a lot of high rev bowlers that are using it, because they can't get far enough left to get it to come back because of the volume of oil that's used in today's game. Now, if you take these high rev guys, and instead of letting them beat the hell out of the fronts using a urethane ball and putting a resin ball in their hand, it is more likely to spread the wear over a wider array of boards rather than just funneling everything into the track, and over time will actually wear the panels down a lot easier and actually make the proprietor's life a little bit easier as well. Number two is going to be precedence. Every sport's changed their rules. The NHL made their nets bigger. Baseball in 1969 dropped the mound 5 inches. The game changed and the rules changed with it. So why wouldn't bowling do the same thing? And you want to talk about evolution. What sport has evolved faster than bowling? Look at what it was back in 2010 versus what it is today. There's so much about the sport that is different because of the technology advancements that have been so rapid and so significant. So why wouldn't we consider changing the rules because of the fact of this evolution that has been brought upon us by, well, really gifted engineers? Let's just be honest. Companies like Storm and Motive and Brunswick are not going to give up advancing the sport forward. They know that those high performance, highly researched bowling balls are the ones that sell the most. So they're really going to push back if USBC tries to stifle the growth that they can produce through new technology. So because of these technology advancements, the game has changed a ton. And when the game changes, so should the rules. So rather than stifling the growth of the technology and making these companies really have to bicker and argue about what's legal and what isn't with USBC, maybe they should start to just trim off some of the old stuff and just say, okay, bowling is this now. We don't have the old type of bowling balls. We only have these ones. Just give people a less of a scope of bowling balls to work with so as to maintain a more level playing field, but also keep it to where the companies are able to continue to work on advancing the sport in a positive way. And number three is the one you all wanted me to bring up. It is the mismatch of the way that urethane is used on the left side and the right side. We've all bowled that tournament where the lefty with the urethane ball absolutely houses everybody in qualifying. They cannot miss. and all of the righties are struggling and nobody can even come close to the striking pace of that one lefty with that one ball. So because this pairing is so deadly, and because of the fact that a lefty holding a urethane bowling ball is so much different than a righty holding a urethane ball, is it fair to consider the elimination of that type of technology in its entirety? So that's the three reasons why I think we should consider eliminating urethane from the sport of bowling. However, I also have three reasons why I think it should stay. First off, it's a lesser technology. USBC really has no precedent in actually banning lesser technologies at all. I don't know if technically you can still throw a wood bowling ball, but I don't know a rule that exists that says you can't. You can still technically throw a rubber ball. People throw plastic balls all the time. There's no precedent in actually removing any equipment once it has been certified until it becomes illegal, but that's on the top end of the spectrum. And the other side of this lesser technology is the pattern that USBC has exhibited in its actual lane oil patterns is that they really like urethane. It seems that the patterns that they put out for the Masters, the US Open, and for Nationals, and the other large tournaments that USBC puts together, urethane shines. Urethane is a necessity to keep yourself in play on both sides of the lane. So because of the fact that USBC puts together these large events and they have the tendency to really amplify the need and also the success of the urethane type bowling balls, and I don't foresee that changing anytime soon, I think that banning urethane would be a bad idea. Number two on the list is the fact that any ball, regardless of the amount and type of technology that is in it, can and will create carry down. Any ball is going to be able to blow the fronts apart. Now, balls that are lower differential and have shorter pin distances will create more carry down because they flare less, and overall, the ball's gonna rotate on that oil slick that it picks up in the middle part of the lane and drop it at the break point or even beyond. But carry down is inevitable, and there's no type of bowling ball that's gonna say, nope, carry down's never a thing ever again, because if I put a 0-inch pin on any ball, it's just gonna flare over that one spot, and that's what's going to happen. It's going to pick up oil, and it's going to lay it back down at the beyond the end of the oil pattern. It's not about the cover that creates this problem. It's about the differential. Any ball, no matter what the cover type, will create carry down. So eliminating urethane really doesn't give a proprietor that much defense against those that are going to blow apart the fronts and also ruin their lane patterns at some point during league. If I really want to be mean and I want to play defense, I can do that with any kind of bowling ball, regardless of the cover type. Urethane just has a higher tendency to make this happen because most of them are low differential type bowling balls. The covers are harder, so they're going to maintain oil on the outer part of the ball. It's not going to soak in quite as fast, so it does happen a little bit quicker, but it really doesn't matter. You give me any ball, I can ruin a lane pattern. And number three on the list is I do not care if you want it to be banned. If you don't like other people throwing urethane against you, learn how to use it. Bowl better. Figure out how to use that technology in your game because it is available to everyone. And the other thing is, if you can't stand getting housed by a lefty who's just matched up with a purple hammer because that's just the way it goes, get over it. They're still second place. They're still third place. Bowling is not about winning every tournament. So if you don't like it, learn how to like it. If you don't like it, learn how to use something else that can help combat it. Figure out how to get around or beat carry down. Practice. Try. Don't just sit back and armchair quarterback USBC into banning urethane just because you don't know what to do with it. But in summary, I really do think urethane should stay. There's really no reason to get rid of it. Yeah, there's some discussion going on. I don't ever see USBC actually making a move like that. It looks like Hammer is going to be releasing three urethane balls all at the same time, so there's no reason to think that the urethane train is going to be slowing down anytime soon. But I want to know what you think. What is your best case for why urethane should stay or why it should go? Do you like seeing it go down the lane? Are you okay with it if it matches up sometimes with these lefties who are really able to just get behind it and just run everybody over? Or do you think it needs to go away? Let me know in the comments. Before we get out of here, please be sure to drop a like on this video and hit that share button. Everything that you can do to help us out, we really appreciate. So thank you very much for whatever you can do. But that's going to be it for this one, guys. Thanks for checking it out. And don't forget, your best life is a 10-pin life. See ya.